Hey guys, so today you and I are going to talk about boot camps. So let's get into it. So the question in question was, Frederick, are boot camps worth it? And the short answer is, depends, but probably yes. Let me explain. So the reason why I think boot camps are worth the investment that you make, it very much depends now, guys, on how much you're going to pay for this. And it also depends a little bit on the boot camp. Now, there are many, many useful courses and good boot camps out on the internet, but I have made a video before which touches on some boot camps that are a little bit, you should be careful. This is the thing I want you to remember. Because in the other videos that where this question has come up has been related to job guaranteed boot camps. And that's a very dangerous thing. And there are a lot of people who get exploited if they... You set yourself up for a big disappointment if you think that there's such a thing as a free lunch. That's all I'm saying. You have to put in the work yourself most of the time. But boot camps in general are a good way for you to gain structured learning. That's the key thing here, because being self-taught is, although it's very feasible, it's very hard for you to figure out all the parts that will be relevant for you in order to do professional grade software development. It's the same thing with having a college degree or an official education. There's nobody out there who's claiming that there's some, and if they are, they're lying to you, because it's not true. If there's someone out there who's telling you that, oh, if you take this boot camp here, you're guaranteed to get a job at Google, or you're guaranteed to be smarter than everybody else, they're bullshitting you. There is no education on this planet Earth when it comes to programming that is going to give you such an edge that they're going to be able to train you in a mystical way that nobody else can train you. The information is out there. Everybody has access to it, more or less, if you have access to the internet. With that said, what I believe is that if you are learning all by yourself without any structured curriculum or courses or official education or anything like that, it just makes it harder for you to find all the right pieces of information. You can still do it. You can still just skip the courses or skip college and do all of this stuff and still make it into the industry, but you will most likely have to work a lot harder for it. That's what you're paying them for, to make it easier on yourself. So that's an important factor. Another important factor which has to be weighed here is when I say that I think that boot camps are a good thing. I think that college education is also a good thing, but you have to understand what it is that you are paying for. If you think that they are equivalent, then you're wrong. This is not true. If you take a boot camp course of a few months versus a full college education, these things are going to weigh differently in the marketplace. I can promise you that. It's not as important once you have some work experience. If you can, let's say for the sake of argument, find yourself in a situation where you're fairly certain that you can get a job working after just a boot camp, and then you can get some work experience. After a few years of work experience, the college degrees and the boot camp, things like that, they're almost irrelevant. That's basically what I'm saying to you. They become, not all the time, but for most intent and purposes, that's not going to matter when you have a certain amount of years of work experience. When they matter the most is for the first couple of jobs, or especially the first job, because then you are basically unproven. And if you're an unproven developer, that is one of the worst things. I've said this many times before. The first job is going to be the hardest one for you, because very few companies want to invest in junior developers, or at least unproven developers. You can be a junior with a year or two of experience, but very few people want to be your first job, if that makes sense, because they ideally want to make sure that they're hiring people that can be trained very quickly so that they can produce value for the company. But in general, boot camps are a good idea. If college isn't right for you, then the boot camp is the second best thing you can do. That's pretty much what I'm saying here. So what I want you to take away from this is that I do believe that boot camps are a good investment for you if college is too expensive or if it's not for you, if it's too long, something like that. What you should be aware of is that there are varying degrees of quality of these boot camps, and especially if they're offering you like job guarantee deals or stuff like that, you should be very skeptical to that. You should be very careful. You need to be able to trust the boot camp if you're going to go down that route. But if you can find a boot camp that you can trust that has a good recommendation, good recommendations and things like that, then go for it, because structured learning will help a lot when it comes to understanding what you need in order to go and become a professional software developer. But apart from that, you also should know that the time that you invest in your education also weighs a lot when it comes to getting a job. If you spend just a few months on a boot camp, you are not going to be as highly valued in the marketplace as someone who goes and takes a full college education. That's something you should remember. Remember that this is a factor. That doesn't mean that you can't make it. It's just going to be a factor. If you're certain that you are fairly confident that you can make it with just a boot camp or like a shorter education, go for it. Because once you're in, after a little while, these, like, your education is going to matter very little. Have a great day.